Hello everybody, welcome back to another tutorial video. Today we will be handling 2D health bars. Ready? Let's go! First, let's define the constraints of our task. We want a health bar to move around with the enemy and display its current health right above its head. On the enemy, let's create a canvas and set up screen space overlay. Next, sliders work really well. So, let us create one which is not interactable, has no transitions, and no navigation configured. We also do not need the handle, so it can be removed without any issues. And, for the sake of simplicity, let us remove the default sprites, so that we get square health bars. You can add any sprite you'd like here. It's starting to take form, but the background can be a bit lighter than our current background. That seems about right. As for the white fill color, we will set that via the script. On that note, let's create a new script called health bar behavior and open it. We need a couple properties. A slider called slider, 10 points on naming conventions, and two colors, one called low and the other called high. And finally, a vector 3 property called offset. We will use this because not all characters have the same height. The script should, in principle, do two things. The first is to move the slider with the parent object, so let us do that in the update method. Equals camera.main.world.screenPoint and we're passing the parent position plus our offset. Side note on the world to screen point. It basically transforms the position from a 3D world position to a 2D screen point. Effectively, where you see the object on the screen. We will do a whole tutorial on these methods at a later stage, since they are incredibly useful. That's it for the movement. Finally, we need one more method, called setHealth. It will take two parameters, one for health, and another for max health. The health bar should only be visible when the enemy is not at full health. As for the actual health bar, we will set the slider's value property to our current health, and the slider's max value property with our max health. And for the final line of code, we set the color of the health bar, dependent on how hurt the enemy is. It adds a nice touch. Equals color.lerp. For the minimum value, low, and for the maximum value, high. And for the lerp value, slider.normalizeValue. Slider.normalizeValue is a value between 0 and 1, effectively the percentage, which we use to pick the color between the low and high values. Alright, the health bar is done, so let's configure the enemy behavior to make use of it. We can add a single property called health bar, and call the setHealth method wherever we update the health values. Let's head back to Unity and set up the health bar. Add the new behavior to the health bar canvas and drag in the slider. For the low color, let's use pure red. And for the high color, let's use pure green. And finally, on the enemy, we drag in the health bar and hit play. As you can see, the health bar is not visible. That's expected because the enemy is at full health. There you go. Now you have a working health bar. And done! In less than 5 minutes, you now know how to implement 2D health bars in Unity. Head over to Patreon to see how you can suggest new videos and vote on our new content. We'll leave a link in the description below. And don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and notification buttons to stay up to date with our 5-minute tutorial series. Let us know what you think about this video in the comments below. Further, we're happy to answer any questions you may have about Unity on our Discord. And that's a wrap. See you in the next one.